The Abadi town is ancient city and it's known living with other people in peace and harmony. Today, Harar has been known in the world as a city of peace. The establishment of Harar dates back to the first millennium and it's among those cities in East Africa that enjoy a mild climate throughout the year, which makes it immediately attractive to the contemporary tourist. Harar is the only permanent settlement in East Africa, the reported seat of Muslim learning. Harar is one of the most important economic centers in the region. Currently, we have devoted our time to conserve our heritage and reconstruct for the future generation. Moreover, in the rural areas, there are so many developmental activities.
Ethiopia is a land of ancient and amazing historical heritages. One of the unique treasures which stand in witness of these heritages is the walled city of Harar, a city founded by people who are believed to be descendants of the Hala tribe. According to recorded history, Harar was established as an autonomous state in the 9th century during the reign of the first emir of the city, Emir Haboba, after its first emir Harar had been ruled by 72 emirs until 1887. It's believed that Islam was first introduced to Harar via the port of Zeila by traders and followers of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Recorded history depicts that Harar, one of the major Islamic centers in Ethiopia, was ruled for centuries by imams and emirs. The city of Harar is one of the seven Muslim dynasties under the Adal dynasty found in eastern Ethiopia. This historic city is said to be the base for the followers of Islam in East Africa. Historians agree that Sheikh Abadir played a key role in resolving tribal conflict in the first millennium and enabled the city to ensure good governance and modern administration. He also gave the city its present name, Harar.
Harar was known as a state in the first millennium with Amir Habuba. Beginning from that time, it has been known with Abadis. There was traditional federalism from Harar up to Gebe region. In this region, there was a great tendency to introduce Islam. So, Harar is the only town in East Africa to introducing and expanding Islamic religion.
Harar is known to be one of the most popular tourist destinations in Ethiopia, boasting more than 90 mosques and numerous spiritual sites and cemeteries. Harar, for most people, is the fourth holiest Islamic city next to Mecca, Medina and Jerusalem. The city of Harar, as a center of trade in eastern Ethiopia, has direct trade relations with Berbera and Zeila. Due to the favorable geographical location of the city, Harar became a very suitable place to cultivate Islamic culture. Harar has always been a unique town where trade and culture meet to create a prosperous and civilized society. Due to its proximity to the Berbera and Djibouti, The city of Harar currently plays a vital role to Ethiopian economy.
The most thriving commercial hub of all urban centers in Ethiopia at that time was the old world jugal city of Harar. That's why we see it repeatedly mentioned in historical records of major trade routes. It was a privilege for me to visit Harar and attend the millennium celebration held there with the intention of renovating the city. I was able to better understand the place of Harar in Ethiopia's long history. Harar was also the first settlement of Muslims in Ethiopia. I remember seeing invaluable heritage reflecting the history of Islam during my first visit to Harar.
The name Harar is closely associated with the 42nd Emir of the city, Nur bin Mujahid. The historic wall of Harar was constructed under the reign of Emir Nur from 1559 to 1567 and still stands as a major tourist site, despite the destruction of some heritages of the city due to the clashes in the region during the 16th and 18th centuries. After fortifying itself in the shade of its wall, the city of Harar remained the only city-state in East Africa that maintained its sovereignty for three centuries. The defensive wall constructed by Emir Nur, known as Jugal, was built from locally obtained materials such as mud and stone by indigenous builders. The wall still serves as a symbol of historic treasure and pride to its inhabitants. It also became the source of subsistence to the Harari people to date, along with other heritages. Jugal covers an area of 48 hectares and stretches over a length of 3,348 meters. It rises to a height of 3 to 4 meters. The Hararis still live in Jugal in harmony and mutual cooperation. The walled city of Harar has five gates symbolizing the five daily prayers by followers of Islam. The doors at each gate depict reminiscence of ancient civilization of the historic city. The wall of Harar had about 24 watchtowers which used to serve as military and security surveillance posts which have now fully been destroyed. Each of the five gates of Harar was named differently in different languages. The gate in the western wing, known in Amharic as Shawaber, is called Asmadin Bari in Harari language and Babul Nasir in Arabic, meaning religion dissemination gate. The southern gate is called Bedrobari as a tribute to the Badr War that once took place between Mecca and Medina during the time of the Prophet, peace be upon him. This gate is also called Babul Hakim or Budabar. The gate facing east is called Sugut At-Bari or Babul Rahma. The fourth gate, known as Argo Bari, mainly serves members of the Argoba nationality. It's called Babul Salam in Arabic. The gate in the northern part is called Asumi Bari, denoting the Red Sea, as Asu means pepper and Mi means water. This is to indicate the reddish color of the Red Sea, resembling the color of red pepper. The gate is also called Babul Zayla in Arabic. The gates of Jugal used to be closed at nightfall and opened at daybreak. Any visitor to the walled city used to be registered and there was also a customs checkpoint. A sixth gate, considered to be less prominent than the others, was added towards the end of the 18th century. This gate was called Kufal Bari, which means closed gate. It's now called Dukbar. Duk, attributed to Prince Haile Selassie, the son of Ras Mokonnen. This is the gate now serving as the main entrance and exit of Jugal. Emir Abdullahi, whose photograph we see at this gate, was the last king of the Daudiya dynasty and the 72nd Emir of Harar. A monument was built at a place called Faras Megala in commemoration of the martyrs at the war towards the end of the reign of Emir Abdullahi. The defeat of Emir Abdullahi by Menelik II at the Battle of Chalenko in 1887 resulted in Hararis being a minority in their own indigenous region. There are 362 named streets in Jugal, among which Mekina Girgir, Megrawawiger, and Imer Uga are just a few to mention. People who know the history of the naming of these streets say that the name Megrawawiger was given to this very narrow path to indicate that it's too narrow that even when two people who are not in good terms run into one another, they cannot pass without touching each other. As a result, they will be reconciled. Similar to the existence of street names in Jugal, names of villages are found in abundance. Dusmegala or Honey Market, Shewashtoya and Faras Megala are some of the prominent ones. The 16th century impressive architectural skills of the Harari still reflected in the traditional housing construction and the design of narrow paths and sewage disposal canals, which have won the wonderment of numerous visitors to date. The Harari housing construction combines absolute beauty and amazing architectural features while maintaining local glamour. One might imagine that these houses were built by well-educated architects or engineers when they see the symmetrical and well-balanced surfaces of the houses. The houses were also built in such a way that weather change wouldn't affect their inhabitants. The roof of a traditional Harari house is called dika and is made from stone, wood and soil. It's often used to sun-dry coffee. There are so many Harari cultural houses which were built by Harari people, and all of these houses were reflectors of the Harari history, way of life and classical modernization. The main building, especially the living room with five raised platforms and the basketwork and wooden bowls, have a lot to tell each and every corner, including the different niches which can be associated with social and symbolic functions. There is also a storeroom used as container of agricultural products in the past. The living room of a typical Harari house is much wider than the other rooms and contains five wide rectangular seats made of beaten earth. Apart from symbolizing the five pillars of Islam, these seats have their own distinctive functions. The five seats are used by Hararis according to seniority and depth of knowledge of the religion. The walls of the house are fully decorated with traditional household handicrafts made by Harari women. The Harari women shoulder the responsibility of the preservation of the colorful traditional costume and the making of the city-renowned basketry. Harar is a city of magnificent handicrafts. It's well known for its colorful and artistic handmade baskets, ornaments, wooden households and different jewelry made of gold, silver, bronze, metal and other precious stones. The jewel of the East is rich in jewelries, and this can be justified with more than 100 jewelries. Most jewelries are worn by Harari women in different occasions and holidays. Women's clothing in Harar is a direct reflection of their colorful culture. Harari women wear traditional dresses with bright and powerful colors, which makes them uniquely noticeable. If a Harari woman has to go to a funeral right after attending a wedding ceremony, she can easily turn her costume inside out and go directly to the funeral without the need to change. Most Harari women play an indispensable role in the preservation of Harari identity. Their socio-economic dynamics are immeasurable. They dominate the market scene. They give a lively atmosphere to major social occasions such as weddings and mourning and many other ritual practices. Harar is very well known for its coffee, a stimulating tubal plant locally known as jat, as well as for a variety of its fruits. Coffee Harar, otherwise known as coffee arabica, has won great recognition for its rich flavor and is regarded as the best coffee variety in Ethiopia and across the world. Hararis make drinks other than coffee from the coffee plant. They make different types of tea, locally known as kuti and kamertasa, from the leaves of a coffee plant. Coffee shell is used for making another type of coffee called hasher. The undeveloped part of the coffee plant, which they call wahber, is mixed with butter and served with a traditional dish called siri. Hararis have drunk coffee and chewed chat for ages. Chat is believed to be a holy plant in Harar. They chew jat whenever they say their dua. It's a multi-purpose plant in Harar and is highly used to perform religious practices, to prepare handwritten books, as well as ease the pressure of heavy work. It's also used by men as present to their future in-laws when asking to take the hand of their daughters in marriage.
In Harar, as opposed to other places, coffee and chat are no more fortunes of the wild forest. They were domesticated centuries back, and ever since, they remain to be the staple garden crops of Hararis.
The naturally endowed historic city of Harar has innumerable and amazing treasures in it. The historic city of Harar not only hosts spiritual sites, mosques and cemeteries, but also boasts different museums, including the Harar National Museum, which houses the extraordinary cultural treasures of the different nations and nationalities of Harar and its surroundings. One of the various museums of Harar is a museum locally known as Adagar. This museum is a community museum home to treasures that reflect the long tradition of how the Hararis preserved and handed down their cultures from generation to generation. Another very notable museum in Harar is the Museum of Arthur Rimbaud, a museum named after a French poet who once lived in Harar for 10 years. This museum hosts various historical records and handicrafts and is also used as an exhibition and French language training center. Different research documents about the city of Harar and ancient photographs can be found in this museum. Abdullah Sharif Museum is another important museum established in the name of the man who pioneered in collecting Ethiopia's heritages found outside Harar. In this museum, one can find ancient religious scriptures, cultural artifacts, and old books written by hand. Harar is historically known for the preservation of handwritten books with leather cover to preserve history for posterity. Ancient Hararese money is also displayed in this very museum, proving that Harar had issued and used its own currency generations ago. The Kingdom of Harar was the second kingdom to issue money in Ethiopia, following the Kingdom of Aksum. The first coins of Emperor Menelik II as well were issued in this historic city. This broad and stable economic base helped Harar to become one of the leading centers of learning in the Horn of Africa and to develop a unique urban culture.
Abdullah Sharif Museum, which is the first of its kind in Harar, which comprises extremely valuable manuscripts and artifacts. And artifacts from the Emirates of Harar many hundreds of years ago. Some of these manuscripts written in Arabic language are of extreme value because they reflect and they represent and they embody the rich heritage and the scientific quality of all those scholars who lived in Harar and who enriched the intellectual life of the city throughout the centuries.
Within the old world Jugal city of Harar are found houses of high architectural value that reflect the beautiful culture and tradition of the Harari people. I am not exaggerating when I say that each and every house within the Jugal Castle is a museum on its own.
The mosques in Jugal are located in such a way that every family can access them easily for the sake of respecting prayer times and safeguarding Islam. Jami is the biggest and most prominent mosques in Harar. It was built in the 12th century and hosts a large congregation, especially on Fridays, for day-long weekly prayers. The other amazing historical feature of Harar is its preservation of the worshipping sites of spiritual fathers. The grave of Abu Sayyid Ali, found in the southwestern part of Gidir Megala, is one of the wonderful treasures of Harar. Abu Sayyid Ali was once the spiritual leader of the city of Harar. Another remarkable grave is that of Sheikh Abadirs, which is found in the southwestern direction of Harar city. The grave is still being used as a place of visit by the Muslim community. Other graves of similar importance include that of Emir Nur and Ayy Abidas, which fascinates visitors to the site. The grave of Abu Sofi, a preacher who lived 1,000 years ago, is still another profound heritage in the cemetery. While this site is used as a religious center for many followers of Islam, it's a spectacular place of peace and quiet. Abu Sofi lived during the reign of Abadir and established the first Quran school together with Abadir. This school gradually gained recognition and expanded throughout Jugal. The teaching method and the curriculum used in Abu Sofi Quran school are still used in a few modern Quran schools or Qurangay. Hararis celebrate different holidays. Shawl Eid is a unique cultural ceremony of Harar and Hararis. It's believed by Hararis that the 6 days of fasting in the Shawl month is considered as equivalent to fasting 1 year. On the seventh day, there is a biggest holiday called Shawl Eid, Shawwal Eid is also a big day which young Hararis dearly look forward to, choosing their future life partners. There's also another festival called Ashura. Ashura is celebrated by crushing a freshly cut gourd. During this festival, hyenas are fed porridge prepared by local worshipping places. The birth of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is another big holiday for the people of Harar. Richard Burton was one of the greatest history writers of his time. He was also the first European ever to visit the city of Harar after a series of trials. Back then, there was a strict belief that in order to get into the city of Harar, one had to be a Muslim. Therefore, Burton had to give himself a makeover so as to look like a Muslim merchant and enter the city. After his visit, he wrote a book called The First Footsteps in East Africa. This great historian described the weather of Harar by quoting the phrase "warm yet not hot, cold yet not freezing" from the Persian poet of the time. Today, Harar is one of the 9 regional administrations under the federal government. 526 kilometers away from the capital city Addis Ababa, with a total area of 340 square kilometers, Harar is an ancient city known for its favorable weather condition and developing infrastructure. Harar city is also called the city of Abadir, the city of Awliyas, the fourth holiest city of Muslims, and many more. These names confirm how rich the city is in terms of culture, religion, and history. Though open for new cultures and experiences, Harar has always held on to its own identity and traditions. This promising city has been recognized and recorded by the United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization UNESCO as one of the ancient cities of the world.
City of Harar is a very important cultural heritage of humanity. It has been selected by UNESCO as a World Heritage Site in 2006, and a certificate was issued to the city to that effect during the millennium celebrations of Harar last July. Harar, of course, is a unique World Heritage Site. It is a city that symbolizes the civilization that has characterized not only Ethiopia but the whole region, the Horn of Africa, the Red Sea civilization, and Islamic civilization.
The people of Harar are known for their easygoing and respectful characteristics. Anyone who gets a chance to visit Harar can easily witness their hospitality. Hararis proudly tell that they inherited these precious values from their spiritual father, Sheikh Abadir. Hararis are not only determined to preserve their cultural and social values, but also to pass them on to generations as valuable as they are.
I've been to Harar many times. Personally,
I have visited Harar together with my family. What makes Harar special is that it is not a destination you visit once and forget. Once you are acquainted with Hararis, then they'll take you home, comfort you with their kind hospitality, and put you at ease. So, Once you had been to Harar, you cannot help going back and again. It's like falling in love with somebody. Harar and the environs are exerting relentless efforts to attract tourists from countries around the world. The tolerance and hospitality, as well as the underlying rich history of the Harar people, are very exciting to visitors. Harar is really worth visiting, not only to Ethiopians and neighboring nations, but also to tourists worldwide. Particularly, those people who are suffering from cultural deserts should visit Harar at least once in their lifetime.
The people of Harar are compassionate. They even have a small social institution called Afocha, in which they help each other in times of hardship.
Harar evolved its own unique social organization called Afocha. There are three types. The first type of Afocha is practiced when there is a festival or funeral. The second one is known as a village Afocha, used when there is a road construction or sanitary activities. The third Afocha is used when there are agricultural activities.
Hararis live in peace and harmony with all humankind. Although there are so many different religious groups throughout the city, the people of Harar acknowledge each group's belief with respect. After all, they even live in harmony with hyenas, let alone human beings. The cathedral of Medhanelem once upon a time was a mosque, but now changed into a church, which shows the Harari culture of peace and harmony. Taking all this into account, UNESCO also named Harar a city of peace and harmony in 2004. In the evening, the hyenas come out of the dark shade and devour the garbage all over the city. Hyenas are a big part of the Harari culture. There are even holes called Waraba Nudul around the walls of Jugal, specially made for hyenas so that they could easily get in and out of the city. Feeding the hyenas is an ancient tradition of the Harari people. Nowadays, the practice of hand-feeding hyenas is not only done by the locals, but also by tourists coming to the holy city of Harar. If there is one place where hyenas don't harm people, it would definitely be Harar. Harar is surrounded by many other historical sites and tourist attractions. The village of Burka is only 5 kilometers away from the village of Sofi. In Burka, there is an ancient mosque called Umakoda. Umakoda is the oldest and most special mosque of the area. Hakim Gara, the hills of Hakim, is the nearest spot to view the entire city of the tremendous Harar. While climbing over the hills, one passes by Aukokhe Cave. They pay a visit to Hakim and Au Abdul Kader. Also, the Erer Cave, which is a gorgeous natural attraction, is found in this locality. In the year 693, Agobas migrated from Arabia to Harar. These descendants of Arab now live in the mountainous villages of Qurami and Imardin to the south of Harar. According to the archaeological findings of the region, Hararis are believed to be the descendants of the Hala tribe. There are three archaeological findings of the Hala village. The first one is located around Sofi village. The second is found midway between Harar and Diredoa, and the third is in the southern part of Harar. The Hala villages are surrounded by walls constructed from rocks of huge limestone. These two tribes, Hararis and Argobas, live in complete peace and harmony, bonding with language, history and culture up until this day. Babile is one of the nearby towns to Harar. This small town is well known for its formation of rocks as a result of volcanic activities. The rocks are incredibly attached to one another. Babile Elephant Sanctuary was established originally for the protection of the endemic race of elephant and is one of the tourist attraction places around Harar. In addition to Argobas, Hararis also live in a friendly manner with the nearby Oromo, Afar, Somali and Silt'e nationalities for generations. Holding on to its ancient values and experiences, Harar is working towards development and experience sharing. Nowadays, the city is involved in different economic, cultural and social aspects by creating sisterly ties with great nations of the world like United States of America, France, Spain, Turkey and Djibouti.
Harar.
A hub of commerce and a center of Islamic civilization as it was, Harar has strong relations with countries of the Middle East, which still remains. As a result, trade exchange between Ethiopia and other countries was made via Harar.
In Harar, the celebration of the Ethiopian millennium began way before other regional cities. The actual celebration took place in the city of Harar with the presence of the Federal Democratic Republic of Ethiopia Prime Minister Meles Zenawi, ministers, ambassadors, regional presidents, high government officials, natives and friends of the region. Harar's Millennium Office is working on different activities by setting a vision to preserve the city's historical image and ensuring its sustainability.
It is my conviction that the third Ethiopian millennium will be an era for the nations, nationalities and peoples of Ethiopia to realize development, democracy and good governance and living in equality, fraternity, love, respect and tolerance more than ever before. It will be a time when the whole of Ethiopia would replicate Harar and Hararis and likewise become land of peace, love and prosperity.
Being one of the biggest cities of Ethiopia with a variety of nations and nationalities, Harar is dedicated to meet expectations in different fields. Thanks to its high position in trade and culture, Harar came to be considered as a sort of capital city of Islamic Northeast Africa. No other town could compete with Harar in the land which stretches from the Somali coast to the Blue Nile. This prominent economic and cultural status of the city is still reflected in its architectural designs. In this regard, the town of Harar has a high potential to the tourism industry development. Like one of the major cities in Ethiopia, Harar is striving to its level best and has registered amicable development results. As historic and ancient the city is, Harar is convenient for investment and attractive for tourism. It has comfortable weather and beautiful landscape. It's rich in natural resources, culture and history with good infrastructure and administration. Therefore, the Harar Regional Government invites investors, NGOs, natives and friends of the region to invest in tourism, education, health and different commercial and industrial activities.
The peoples of Harar and the peoples of Ethiopia Harar has good condition to developmental activities. So, come to our town and fulfill your vision.
Pack your six senses. Come to Harar, a city of experience and senses, where the old meets the new.
Harare, 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 Har